these will get like Steam workshop support for mods and stuff. Recently I went back and installed some mods manually for a couple games, and yeah, it's definitely like more work, and each mod, even for the same game, kind of has its own installation rules you gotta read and play by. So that definitely makes things easier when you can just click a subscribe button and get it working. But Mirror's Edge Catalyst, I played the first one, never played that one, but pretty cool concept. Got your Dragon Age games here. Other ones I've never played before, but everything's like 50 to 75% off. Here's the original Mirror's Edge, all the Crysis games, Medal of Honor, which really isn't worth playing, I don't think. It's, I don't know, I don't remember really liking it. I think it was like buggy, and I'm not sure how Medal of Honor fell so far behind Call of Duty, but this was like their last-ditch attempt to imitate Call of Duty Modern Warfare. But Medal of Honor Airborne, I think that one's more fun than Medal of Honor, because you can actually like jump out of a plane and land at different parts of the map and stuff, which is kind of cool. Yeah, here's the RPGs. Dragon Age Origins is one of my favorites. Awakening was a pretty good addition on top of that. I'm not sure how well Jade Empire has aged, but I remember liking it a lot at the time. I thought it had a cool story, and the martial arts combat system, I think, was cool for the day. Yeah, I haven't played that in such a long time, I don't know. Maybe there's cool mods for it and stuff. We have that to start us out. I can't remember if I've played much of the first Command & Conquer, but I guess it's just just remastering, so better graphics for it, and just having it on Steam and actually working well on a modern computer is probably a big deal for an old game like that. But I'll just put Steam on the bottom of the stack here, and we'll go through that later. GOG has a Total Annihilation Commander Pack for free. I think you might have to make an account, or I don't know, maybe sign up for a newsletter, whatever hoops they make you jump through, but you can't get it for free. Do they have anything good? Heard good things about Firewatch, but never played it personally. Oh, is GOG doing bundles now? We'll take a look at that. I bought Greedfall on Xbox. I'm gonna have to try that out soon and let you guys know how that is. says, but I'm going to click on it and find out. Was it Vagris? The Riven Realms. Okay. Might just be a demo like it said here. Prey is 70% off. That's a fun one. Alright. And lots of other bundles. I didn't even know that they were doing bundles, but we will take a look at some of them briefly. I don't usually buy from GOG, but, or not in a long time, but I'll just see what they have. Frostpunk is good, Moonlighter. Across those are the ones that really jump out at me. I think B-Cop was it in a Humble Choice recently? I don't know. I saw it free somewhere. RPGs. I remember having fun with Bound by Flame a long time ago. Probably not super impressive, but fun enough. Divinity is definitely good, but I think there's been better sales than these. Well, I don't know. Has it been down to like 25 or something? Or 30? A little bit less. GOG doesn't have access to Bannerlord, or it's not on sale. Let's check. Oops. Thinking about it. Oh yeah, I didn't really like that one. I bought it anyway thinking I might, but the Viking Conquest, it was based on another mod for Warband that I also didn't really like, but I think a lot of people did. It just added like a lot of weird things that I didn't really like. Like, there's a percentage chance that you'll just like, I think like trip and fall on your face in combat for some reason. And after battles you have to actually like spend time either burying the dead or healing or looting. And people can attack you right after. I mean, I guess that's a bit more accurate. Just inconvenient as well. What are we in now? Highest rated. Some of these kind of surprise me. I know they're, that one is a classic and it is good, but there's a lot of old ones in these in here as well, but I guess that makes sense for GOG. FDL, yep. Dang. Not as much love for Dragon Age, only almost 2K. That kind of puts it at the bottom of the barrel of the top 50. Gothic Games. Outcast. Yeah, they did a remake of that, like, last year, the year before that or something. Kind of want to play it. I think I actually do have it from something. Roller Coaster Tycoon. I don't know, I'm just reading titles now at this point and reminiscing. But, yeah, pretty decent sales across these. I liked Pharaoh and Cleopatra a lot back in the day. That was like my top, city building type game. Alright, anyway. Witcher Games. this is a demo. I guess it's free. Oh, just the prologue. But what do you look like? That didn't tell me much information, but I don't know. Could be fun. Summer sale. That's not a very long. Oh, buy three or more for a higher discount, but that's not a very long list. Children of Morta is good, but what's that? I don't know, 25% or something. That's a long list of adventure games. Jill, like, oh, farming an animal. solving with physics and stuff. Kind of reminds me of Human Fall Flat a little bit. But that's cool. Has like combat and stuff in it too. What does it say? Metroidvania. Mostly exploration and puzzles and a little bit of fighting sprinkled in. So, I don't know. It could be fun. Definitely does remind me of the puzzles and the goofiness of Human Fall Flat. But, yeah. That is that humble choice. If you have Twitch Prime, then you have access to a number of games in June. Max, the Curse of Brotherhood, Steel Rats, The Flame in the Flood, that's good, I've played that. Dream Daddy, which is like a single dad dating simulator where you date other dads. It's a weird concept, but I think it has good reviews, and I've listened to the trailer, and it has an interesting song in it. It's kind of like a meme with me and my wife will just randomly sing that first part of that song for some reason. Yeah, number of other games, Project Warlock, Forsaken Remastered, The Last Tinker, City of Colors, Silence, Observer, and even more, I guess. I didn't really see these when I looked earlier. But I've heard of a number of these. The big one I think that just unlocked recently was Dream Daddy. Origin has some sales going on, but let's see if there's anything that amazing. I just pulled it up without looking too closely. One that was on my wish list that popped up. 40% off. I do wanna play this and maybe hopefully get my friends on board with it and playing through that, but it seems like a fun third person shooter or melee RPG adventure here. Pretty good reviews. So yeah, me and my friends have a lot of multiplayer games stacking up. We have to work through. We're playing through Borderlands 3 right now. The Daedalic Gigantic Bundle. If you like their type of games, I think there's a lot of there's different games than I was expecting. I don't know what that one is. Yeah, that one's, I didn't know they had an RTS city builder. But yeah, they have this RPG strategy one. I think a lot of point and click ones do, puzzle games. It's marked down from 130 to 13. That's pretty good. And we'll take a look at this too. Why not? I have a feeling this is going to be like an old game intro that absolutely tells us nothing about it. Yeah. Why even make that? Alright, we got the ship. We're setting sail. We got the seagulls. And let's get at it. The art style is actually pretty interesting. I wonder how it plays. yourself store. I never played that, but I remember it looking cool. Maybe we can find it. I don't know, is it somewhere else? Would it be on Steam? Xbox really needs to show you. Yeah, a lot of people like it, so that's a good sign. That's a lot of 5 stars. It doesn't show you, like, anything about the game. Eh, nothing's worth that. Alright. The Chucklefish 9th Anniversary Publisher Sale. What did it be? Time Spinner. I've never heard of that, but I like a lot of the games that Chucklefish has produced. List on Steam, so I don't know if I'll get it now, but I definitely want to pick it up. It's kind of like, you know, Advance Wars / Fire Emblems type of deal, and I really like those games growing up, so Pathway, I think the reviews for that, I think it had like a rocky start, but it seemed like an interesting concept there. Like, I don't know, strategy, RPG, yeah, is what they say. It doesn't even say roguelike, but if I'm remembering this game correctly, I think it did kind of have branching paths on the little random adventure you go on. Time Spare, oh, that was released in 2018. Metroidvania-E. Well, that's what it says, and I think that's what we read earlier. Coming soon, in most. That has some cool graphics, actually. All that interesting lighting going on. I like that. Starmancer. DLC coming out. But yeah, I'm interested in this. It has like some multiplayer campaigns and stuff now as well, which is one of the reasons I like that. What is in that? So this bundle is halfway. Which I'm not sure I've seen that before. Seems like it could be fun. Starbound. We looked at that one. All these. I mean, that I'm sure you'd have a lot of fun with all the games in here for $34. It's a pretty good price. 6 overall. The Spec Ops line is pretty fun. Got all your Borderlands here. And I think earlier in the week, Borderlands, the Handsome Jack collection or something, was free on Epic, but I didn't have time to make a video of sales then. Since moved on to something else, which we'll find in two tabs from now. How much does it go down? Oh well, that's quite substantial. So let's say, what would you want? Maybe you want to pick up Bioshock Infinite. And let's say you were born in 1987 for some reason. Crazy as a lot of the other AAA titles that they've had on here kind of recently, like Civilization and GTA 5, but it's still pretty cool. It's definitely a fun little couch co-op game that you can play with whoever. List it on here, but if you're like me and played just the tiniest bit of three when one of my friends who really loves it was like trying to teach me it, and it was pretty complicated, and we only played it one time. So I don't have much nostalgia for this series. But yeah, I feel like World War II and complicated strategy games on this could be for you. And here's the mega sale. I'm playing through a Quantum Break. I played it before, and I'm just playing it again, and my wife is watching it. Sometimes just sitting there watching it, sometimes while she's playing Animal Crossing, which is her favorite thing right now. But she really likes that, and this, I get a similar vibe from it, but I haven't really looked into it too closely. But are there any actual just like pictures? But nope, I guess we're gonna have to watch. I saw something that looked like it, but I want to play Man of Medan, and that was on sale as well. Or it was, maybe it's not anymore. Or as if like a day or two ago it was like half off, but now it's back up. It's like a horror, choose your own adventure story that you can play co-op with people, and that seemed cool to me. It has pretty good reviews. I think the general consensus is that it's not as good as Until Dawn, which was this company's previous title, which I've never played that because I didn't have a PS4 or 5 or anything. Nothing since the PS2. But it seems fun. I think it'd be cool to play through with somebody. You get multiple people playing online. And I think there's a lot, like, because, like, any of the characters, I think, at different points could potentially die based on your choices and things you do. So I wonder what you'd do if you just die and everyone else's characters are still alive. So, I don't know. Seems fun, though. I haven't played a horror game in a very long time. It's usually, I don't know, I guess not something that I normally actively buy, but I think it sounds, I like choose your own adventure things. That just sounds fun. Never heard of Gunfire Reborn. Master Chief. Yeah, somehow the Valve Index is like at the top of the like top sellers list. Or it was like yesterday. Now it's 3. That's a lot of money. There's a lot of people buying. I guess they're stuck at home. They're buying $1,000 VR headsets. Primarily a sale ramble. Okay, we've seen a lot of that, except for the Resident Evil. I guess those games seem to be on sale as well. Did I go back? Let's see. Oh yeah, let's go look at this. So Biohazard, 67% off. Of the Resident Evil ones. I played, I don't know, 3 or 4, I think. Something on the PS3 with someone in college. I've played a little bit of Code Veronica on the Dreamcast. That's way back when. Oh, it's Borrow Drama, so if you don't have the Humble Joys, you can get it for 40% off. This. For a second I thought it was an Humble Choice, but yeah, this was actually in the Twitch Prime thing, right? Like, this was free on Twitch Prime. So yeah, I actually want to give that a try. Looks like, you know, the early Doom games, except on super steroids. Just whatever you call that style of graphics where it's like that fake 3D but really like 2D. There's something kind of charming about it. I think it ages a little bit better. What was it called? There's some like Ultimate Doom, a Brutal Doom mod that just added a ton of crap and levels and weapons and enemies and animations to the original Doom games, and that was just a ton of fun. So yeah, I don't know, I just like that art style. It has that weird effect in the old games where like the items and the enemies and the things are always like spinning to face you for some reason. Excited to play this now. there's that.